So, I lost my phone last night for a few hours when I called the Alamo, which is a movie theater in downtown Raleigh. I think it's like a chain, but it's really cool. I went to see an old-timey movie. Well, old-timey, it's a classic. Indiana Jones and the Temple of Doom on the big screen. So I was so much in a hurry to get back to the movie that I left my phone in the bathroom, but I didn't realize this till like way after the movie. It wasn't too far because it's in downtown Raleigh, and I was hanging out with my buddy, and it wasn't too far, but I lost my phone, and I like called the Alamo. Hey, so I lost my phone, and they're like, can you tell me what the lock screen is? And I kid you not, I said, oh, it's a picture of Boomer. As if anyone doesn't know who Boomer is. Boomer, can you please make a guest appearance?
Hi, honey. Come here. Can I pick you up? One little hi. It's been a while.
You're getting so fluffy. It's like, oh, I'm sorry. My cat. Orange tabby cat. And they were like, oh, okay. Can't believe I said that. I'm like in panic mode. I'm like, it's a picture of Boomer. And they're like, who's Boomer? My cat! I just can't believe I'm that person. I thought I'd give a little life update, telling you about my crazy day, adulting, and my start to summer.
Hi, Boomer!
It's really cool to think about. My mind's, like, not, like, there yet. Events of, like, summer vacation. And I have been, like, working and doing school for, like a year and a half straight, which is like, doesn't seem like a lot, but it is a lot, especially too, because my old nanny job was every Monday and Thursday for 3 hours a day, not including like weekend babysitting jobs. And so I was literally like, even over the summer, it was like summer school or not, I was like, hi Boomer, I was like constantly doing something every single day. That was exhausting, but now I don't have classes, right? Because I've graduated Wake Tech, baby. That AA degree is locked and sealed, and the only reason I have to go back to campus is to pick up my diploma. I am done. Like, done. Like, it's over. This is happening. This is real now. This is, like, a thing that's happening. And this was just there, but, like, it's, like, what in the world, cat? Thank you. Oh, I don't know what I'm gonna do with him when I move. But, so Monday, I woke up at 8:37, woke up and I like looked at the clock and I was like, it'd be really weird to be up at 7:30 because I had set my alarm for 8:01. Well, come to find out, I set my alarm for 8:01 on Tuesday, 7 minutes past the time I needed to leave for my exam. And thankfully, I do not understand how this happened. I defied physics and honestly, I'm not gonna lie, probably every, like, vehicle transportation law ever. Like, crammed everything into a bag and, like, threw everything on, and I was, like, out the door, and I was in my car within 10 minutes. Too, that I didn't put on deodorant or wash my face, like, the whole day, and that was weird. I somehow managed to make it into my classroom by 9:03. I do not understand how I managed to do that. Not to say that that was like the pinnacle of a college experience, but really, Wake Tech, you fulfilled like an extreme stereotype. Like, I never thought I'd be in that position. It's like 8:37, I was like, huh. Holy crap, no. My exam is in less than 20 minutes, and I like booked it. So that was my Monday, and then I took two finals. I went straight to work, and work was so hectic. So I got home, and I, like, with my backpack on and everything, and I do this thing where I'm like, it's happening. I think I've talked about this before. It's just like this, like, overwhelming reaction just like hit the floor. I got it from New Girl, but like, it's just very real to me. I've done it in public spaces. I've done it in parking lots. I think I did it in a Target once, and my mom was like, yeah, I did it, and I was like, it's happening, and I just was like, ugh, and I like slid down like jelly to the floor. So my dad, like, right before I went to bed, was like, well, how do you feel about it? And how he just yelled, like, so passionately. I was like, film school! Yeah, buddy! Like, I was, like, so, like, into it. And I keep thinking that now, like, especially, too, like, and I don't know what it was, but when I was at the Indiana Jones movie last night, which was one of my favorite, like, childhood movies, by the way, The Temple of Doom, but,
you're so cute.
When the Star Wars trailer came on for, like, crap, I really like the name of it too. It's the one that's coming out in December. We were sitting in the front row. We're like really close to the screen, which I've never done before, so that was kind of an experience. And the score for like the Star Wars theme comes on. What? And I even know the name of that one song, and it's like over my head. There goes all my movie trivia. That song came on, and it was just like... amazing. And I almost started like crying. I didn't, but like it was so overwhelming to me, and it was kind of the first time too it like kind of settled down and hit me that I'm actually going to go to film school, that I'm going to do this and like make a movie. Like I even kind of want to cry about it now, but there was just there's something about that trailer that like and on that big screen that just got me. And I honestly think it's just because of how historical and like classic Star Wars is, and the fact that I was like there to watch like Temple of Doom, one of my favorite kids as a, like, favorite movie as a kid. So that was really cool, like yesterday and stuff. And I went on a really long hike. Hiking is like my baby. There's really nothing I love more than that. And it was just a really solid day, and I had ice cream and hanging out with my really good friends, and it was just an awesome day. It was so cool. Like literally like didn't have cell service for like 5 hours, and like I'd even forgotten my phone. Like honestly, the fact that I didn't have my phone on me like was crazy. As soon as I got my phone back, I was like, I hate this. And like, I wanted to just like chuck it at a wall. I was like, I'm done. I was like, I should just flush it down the toilet. Like, I don't need it. Oh, such a crazy day. Really good day. And it was a great grandma start to summer. And then today I did the adulting thing. And I went to two doctor's appointments. And this was really kind of the meat of like, what I wanted to talk about, besides like the fact that like that's my tiny life update, is that it's summer, I've got my AA degree, film school's on its way, oh, I got a haircut, found out today, updated prescription, right eye is not doing very good, stigmatism's getting worse. I wanted to talk about how I royally really went on a wild goose chase today to get paperwork done. So today, this morning, I woke up early and was like, I'll get all my crap done and we won't be late. Well, and naturally I'm not like horribly late, like 5 minutes. Like appointments are usually between like on the dot and like 5 minutes past. It's usually not 10. 10 is like everything else, or like class, which was like really weird because I'm not like, I'll show up pretty much at the dot or like maybe a minute or two after like class, just because like that's just kind of how I am. But like the exam, that was like, I'm not like that. Like I, like if it's anything like crazy like that, or like a movie showing, like I'm there. You see where my priorities lie. Okay, church. And I was supposed to bring books, my American Lit 1 books, which you guys I think have heard me like goo goo gaga over about. And I have an entire Norton Anthology collection because I'm a nerd. My friend, she was like, can I borrow these for my American Lit 1 summer class? And I was like, yes, queen, yes you can. She was like, oh, are you gonna be like in town? I was like, yeah. I was like, so come meet me at like my work and stuff, which my doctor's office is thankfully right behind, and both of them are like not far from my house, so it was really convenient. But I also forgot my paperwork that I initially needed for like immunizations and stuff, like proof of that from my doctor, so I can send those over to UNCW. So I rolled up in this outfit, and I had like a belt on. I'm not wearing the belt now because like it's, you know, it's after four, you don't wear belts after four. And I'm like hopping and bopping. And then I realized, I, like, pulled up too, I was like, I forgot the books, and I forgot the paperwork. It was, like, the two, like, reasons I'm, like, out today. It's like, well, I'll go do my appointment, I'll come back. So I bop in, and I'm like, hi, Gabby Perkins, it's my birthday, and I'm here, I'm new. And I'm, like, the one person who's not, like, retired. This is a very, like, old people doctor. And, like, I've never gone to, like, primary care physician, I think that's what it is, like your primary care doctor instead of like the pediatrician. My like number one thing though, especially too, because like doctor's offices don't make me feel like uncomfy really. I feel like I'm making them uncomfortable. So my only way to like smooth out slightly awkward conversations, I really had like a young nurse, but my favorite thing to do with doctor's offices is like crack jokes. I don't even really have any good ones to share. I just really wanted to tell you guys that I like make these people laugh, and I don't know if it's like they're like desperate, like trying to get me to feel better or what, but like it's just so stupid. Like, wanted to mainly share that I really like doctor's appointments because I really just like getting random laughs. I won't even relay them to you. Like, it's, I don't know where they come from, but they do, and then they happen and someone laughs, and I'm like, that's amazing. forget. I left, and then I had another eye appointment. I had an eye appointment, like, for my prescription after, like, an hour and 40 minutes, like, after my doctor's appointment. And so I was like, okay, so my work is, like, literally right in front of the doctor's office that I go to, which is extremely convenient. Oh, I forgot the paperwork and the books. All instead of, before I go and edit at the coffee shop, I will go home, grab my crap, come back. Got like a little elephant paperclip, which this is an important detail in the story. Got all my stuff together, put the books in a bag so she could take it, and then I got my paperwork together and put it in my backpack, and then I went to my car, went back to the doctor's office, parked across the street at the coffee shop this time, walked across like the parking lot, went to walk into the building, and keep in mind at this point it's noon, and I had a feeling this might happen because I noticed the parking lot was like really empty than when it was when I left. Like, I even thought I heard the doctor's like stomach like growl while I was in there. So like I had the paperwork in my hand and I went to like take it to the front desk to drop off because I'd forgotten it earlier, right? And they locked the doors and were like, sorry, lunch break. And I was like, that's fine, really, that's okay. Like, I can handle that, that's cool. And it said they weren't open till 2. Looks like I'm coming back after my eye appointment. Went left the doctor's office, walked back to the coffee shop, called my mom. I was like, you will not believe what just happened. She's like, oh, girl. And I was like, yeah. Went to the coffee shop, did some no editing, because I realized that I had to fill out the paperwork that I was about to drop off, which I brought a pen to fill out, like, at the doctor's office, but I was like, you know, while I'm here. And then, of course, I'm at my work, so, like, people are talking to me and stuff, and then that kind of ran over a little bit, and then was kind of, like, a few minutes late to my eye appointment, because I was filling out the paperwork, because people were talking to me, and, you know, it was this whole thing, and, like, I gave my friend her books, and I was like, oh, she hung out with me for a bit, and it was really cool, and it was fun, and we're like, oh, summer. Went to my eye appointment, and the one lady at the front desk wasn't really taking my jokes either, which was fine, but then the other girl was, which was really cool, and she was like, look at this house, is it fuzzy? And I was like, yes. Like, okay, and he's like, your prescription is... it's not horrible, your left eye's fine, but we don't want it to, like, overcompensate for the right. And I was like, yeah, I feel you. And so I got that picked out and all that jazz. And, oh, I don't know where my train of thought went, as usual. I'm adulting, and then I did, like, a copay. What's a copay? But I did it. I don't know. I did the copay. They were like, do you want to look at sunglasses? And I was like, no. Oh, here's what it was. The nurse who was helping me before the doctor came in to look at my eyes and stuff, she was like, girl, don't worry. I get my glasses off of Zenni too. She's like, I even get a discount here and I still use Zenni. And I was like, that's so funny. This is really neat. She was like so sweet and stuff. I was like, I could tell. I was like, are you training? She's like, it's my last day. And I was like, congrats. Like, I just make friends with all the nurses and doctors and stuff. Like, just pure, I feel like maybe they're just really good at that, but like, I feel like I'm making friends. And then, for the copay. So I went to my car and it was like, the paperwork. I went back to the doctor's office, back down the street. Thankfully, it's all like on the same block. And meanwhile, I'm like blasting out. I was like, this is just one of those days, to the doctor's office. And I walked into the doctor's office and I realized the paperwork I had was the paperwork from the eye doctor. But I was like, hi, I'm here to turn in some paperwork. My name is, you know, I said my name. And I was like, and here. And I like, looked down and I was like, it's in my car. And the nurse is like, kind of laughed at me at the front desk. And I was like, I'll be right back. My paperwork on my backpack. And I came back and you know, I was so fancy, I did a sticky note and I wrote my name and like my date of birth and my, you know, he didn't have to tell me to do that. I knew to write it, which was fun. And I wrote my doctor's name and I was like, here, and they're like, do you fax it and you want a copy and like come back and pick it up? And I was like, yes, please. So the elephant paperclip, she's like, oh my goodness. She was like, this is so cute. And I was like, thanks. She's like, do you want it back? And I was like, no, you can keep it. And the other two nurses, like, were sitting at the front desk, were like, is that an elephant paperclip? The other lady was like, are you like really sure? And I was like, yeah. She's like, it's so cute. I was like, I know. And she's like, good job. She's like, you started a fight now, Gabrielle. And I was like, this is so funny. And she's like, have a great day. I was like, thank you. And I like literally left the doctor's office like laughing, and like people were laughing behind me. And I was like, boom. I was like, that was some weird like band-aid trash, by the way. The elephant paperclip did me a solid. I just really wanted to share my wild goose chase of like paperwork. Forgot it, right? Was late. Appointment. Gets caught up, tries to fill out, goes back home, brings it back, they're closed, goes to the coffee shop, fills it out, is late to the next appointment because they're filling out the paperwork because people are talking to me and blah, blah, blah. Great conversation, so I wouldn't take any of it back. Eye doctor, and then I'm like, back there, forget it, go back to my car, go back there, give them the paperwork. And the day is done. And I still have yet to edit. I will say, though, not sure when it'll happen, but I am, right, well, I wrote it, but I'm in the process of, like, doing little clips and filming for a little movie idea that I have, because it's summer, baby. Sorry, did you finish the Belize movie yet?
I'm not a film star!